So very good morning to all the students of class plus 1B beta. We are going to start the new chapter today. Before starting, let me discuss that what a coincidence it is. Yesterday we compiled our poem, The Voice of the Rain, and it was a rainy day. You know, we were relishing the poem and it was a rainy day only. And with another coincidence, we are going to start this chapter, The Ailing Planet, The Green Movement's Role. And tomorrow we are going to celebrate Environment Day also. Fine. So this is just a coincidence, but it is definitely a very good coincidence. Fine. We did our poem Rainy, Voice of the Rain on a rainy day, and we are going to do our chapter. We will be starting today and maybe we'll be able to complete it today. Tomorrow only, because this is just an article only. This chapter is written in the form of an article. So it's not that lengthy. So we will be able to complete it on the Environment Day, that is tomorrow. Before starting beta, if you can see, I have written a quote on the board today. One of my personal favorite quotes, let's go green before the green goes. Can anyone tell me the meaning of this quote? Let's go green before the green goes. Very interesting quote it is. Just raise your hand, I will unmute you and you can speak. Let's go green before the green goes. Very easy. Come on, raise your hand. If you won't raise hand, I will be making you speak. You know that. Your class teacher always call names and then you have to speak. Arshpreet, unmute yourself. This way I would be marking absent those who do not answer. And if you don't know, even then you say that, ma'am, I'm not able to understand at least. You can speak that much. The idea is to participate in the conversation. Nobody knows that. Not a single hand raised. See, it is quite surprising. Let's go green before the green goes. Japanpreet, what do you understand with this quote? Japanpreet, at least unmute yourself and say, ma'am, I'm not able to understand. At least you can say that much. Anjali, Japanpreet, you have joined. Now I know. I'm just asking the meaning of this quote. I have just started only. You have joined. We have started only. I'm just saying. I have written a quote on the board. Anybody can tell me the meaning? I have not taught anything so far. This is not a tedious question that you're not able to answer. I'm just asking, let's go green before the green goes. Okay, let's not waste time. But I'm surprised that you're not able to understand such a simple quote. Let's go green before the green goes. Here, green stands for all the greenery, the forest, the plants, the whole environment, right? So here I'm trying to say, let's go green. Let's do plantation. Let's save our environment before the green goes, before it goes out of our hands, before the situation goes out of our hands. Let's save the situation. Let's save the environment before it goes out of our hands. Fine. This is just simple message, but carrying the vast meaning in it, wrapping the vast meaning in it. Okay. So let's go green before the green goes. Why I have written this quote? Tomorrow is Environment Day. Another reason we are going to start this chapter, the ailing planet. Now, ailing planet here means that our earth is like a patient. Before starting or before telling you the content of the chapter, let me tell you the related code and what is the name of the chapter. The ailing planet, the green movement's role. Earth is like a patient in declining health. It is a patient. We people are disturbing the natural resources. We people are the reason behind the depletion of the earth, that it has become a patient only. Right? That's why the earth is patient, and the consequently, we people are also becoming sick because a lot of natural resources are wasted every day, every second, I must say. Fine. Rather than, if we cannot plant, at least we can stop the destruction. We cannot, we're not supposed to pluck the flowers, we're not supposed to cut the trees. You know, people are busy into making their buildings after cutting the forests and all. Fine. So we people are reason behind it. So in this chapter, the ailing planet, the green movement's rule, you can say the two sides of a coin we will be seeing here. What are the two sides of coin? First side is the reasons and the causes behind the depletion of the earth, how it is getting depleted, who is responsible for this. Fine, we will be reading about this in the first part, as well as we will be reading about the green movement's role, which you might have read in your social sciences. What is green movement? Green movement, it started in New Zealand in the year 1972. Clear? So we will be reading about the green movement's role, as well as we will be reading about the causes behind the depletion, and as well as people, how people are becoming conscious also. It's not always a negative thing. How people are becoming conscious of their environment, how they are putting their, you can say, efforts also to safeguard it. Fine. So both the things are there, reasons and causes of depletion, how Earth is becoming a patient, as well as how we can improve it and what can be done for it. Okay. So it is a very, it's this article, I again say this chapter is written in the form of article. It is written by Nani Palkhiwala. Fine. The name is written. So writer has very beautifully, you know, knitted this article. Article writing is also the part of your writing skill. But this is the, you can say, long writing of the article, but you will be writing up to 150 to 200 words only. That will be 1 to 1.5 pages of your paper. Clear? But you can have a fair idea after reading this article that, okay, this is the way that facts are also added. He has added, Nani Palkhiwala has added facts into it. He has added the reasons behind the destruction, awareness of the people, role of green movement, and much more. Fine. So what is green movement? Green movement, you can note down, it started in 1972 in New Zealand. Fine. It is written in your book. You can underline it on the very first page. And then the concept of sustainable development. He would be focusing on concept of sustainable development, means we are not here to use the resources to that extent that they are finished. There are two ways of using the thing. Suppose your mother has cooked the meal, your favorite dish is there, and before serving anyone, he also loves to eat that dish. So rainy season is going on, say it is gajar ka halwa, suppose. So she eats everything, every bit of it, and she does not give it to you. You know that gajar ka halwa is there, but you're not going to get a spoonful out of it even. How would you feel? You feel bad? Okay, we are not, it is there, but you're not supposed to use it. You're not supposed to eat it. Similarly, sustainable development, in simple words, that use the resources, use it, but in such a way that it is left for others also. Fine, don't just finish it off. Similarly, we have to take care of the environment in that extent. We have borrowed it from our posterity, the coming generation. Fine, coming generation, I'm using the word posterity for it. You can note down. Okay, so we should, yes, use resources considering needs of others. So Japanpreet is writing exactly, you got my point. using the resources to that extent that you can also relish it as well as the coming generation is also having it. Fine. So he would be focusing on sustainable development, green movement's role, and how we can save the earth. Fine. And then we need to, you know, meet the demands of the present generation while keeping in mind the necessity of meeting the needs of the future generation as well. This is the main or major concept. Clear? So environmental issues, conservation, how different NGOs, political parties, everybody started this, joined this movement once it started, and it became a universal phenomena after that. Though it started in New Zealand, it became universal phenomena. Fine. So we would be reading about this in detail. Clear? Let's start. I will be just discussing the points you have already noted down. I have given you enough time. So this chapter, The Ailing Planet, The Green Movement's Role, fine, this is the complete name of the chapter only, it's lengthy one. Chapter discusses various environmental issues. Earth is like a patient and declining health. Fine, I've discussed with you depletion of forests, grasslands, fisheries, croplands. All the sectors on this earth are getting affected, not only one. This is a cycle only. The way we have read about, you know, all the creatures, animals, insects, birds, human beings, plants, everything is connected. You might have seen the channel Discovery. They show it accurately how we all, this chain is interconnected. If one species, you know, declines, or if one species get affected, the other species definitely will be affected out of it. If there is, you can say, depletion of one of the species, fine, then it is going to affect that cycle, because one creature eats the other, one is the survival for other. In that way, we all are interconnected in one or the other ways. Being science students, you must understand this. Fine. So depletion of forests, grasslands, fisheries, as well as croplands, they will be discussing this. Domination of humans over other species. Human beings have started misusing the earth. They have started, you know, having that kind of usage of all the resources that it is not leaving anything for other species. It is not bothering about other species. That I should use it, fine? Mean attitude of the human beings is projected here. Then overpopulation and poverty. These two concepts are the reasons that why our, fine. So after discussing beta domination of humans over other species, these two points are the major ones, overpopulation and poverty. Clear? So he would be discussing that how people, because of the population, what happens? This is the concept of economics. Fine. What happens that when more people are there, more population leads to usage of more resources. Fine. More resources are being used. Richer are getting more richer. Poor people are becoming more poorer. Fine. So there is imbalance in the economy. Fine. And with more population, more trees will be cut. More buildings will be, you know, structured. And definitely it is going to harm our environment. That's why I have written, let's go green before the green goes. Clear? And World Environment Day, we are going to celebrate. What an occasion to understand this concept of sustainable development and how we can stop our earth being a patient. And now see, because our earth has become a patient, we people are also facing it. COVID is spreading like anything. And now people are getting aware, okay, we should plant trees. Now people are running and just bringing plants, so that otherwise we have never ever thought about it. There was awareness otherwise. Everybody knows that we should plant trees, grow more trees. Quotes are written on the roadsides even. We read it, but we don't pay attention unless and until we face it. when we ourselves become patient, then our realize that we have made actually our earth a patient. That's why the name of the chapter is Ailing Planet. We can stop that, we can say, we can stop this ailment. Okay, so then next is deforestation. Writer Nani Palkhiwala has beautifully described how people are blindly following the path of deforestation. What should be done? Afforestation should be done. I repeat my term. Means more forest, more plants, more trees should be there. We should grow. At least we can start with, you know, there are people, we celebrate our birthdays, we go out for parties, we waste our amount. Rather than we never think that, okay, we should think our, about ourselves only. We prefer having new dresses on the birthdays, but we never thought, let's plant a tree on my birthday. Maybe by the next birthday, it will be a tree only. Fine, it will grow more and you will be happier to see how you are giving to the environment. Environment giving us back whatever we need, but what we are doing for the environment. Fine. So next is last point. You can see, I'm just going to show you. You have already noted down, human beings are the most dangerous animals. This statement given by the writer is actually one example, a beautiful example will be there in the chapter, that there is one, you know, zoo in Lusaka. The place is Lusaka, Zambia. We would be reading about it in the chapter. And there is a cage, you know. And people think that, okay, there is a cage, there will be one animal over there. People go there and people just, you know, the moment they enter the cage and they are shocked that there is no animal inside that cage. Rather than there is a mirror. Why there is a mirror? That one can reflect one's image. And what is written on the cage, you can see? It is this statement, the most dangerous animal on this earth. Now you got my point, what I'm trying to say. The cage is there and mirror is there, and whosoever, obviously human beings are going to see their image only. And it is written the most dangerous animal. So it means human beings are the most dangerous animals, because even animals, you know, they take care of their surroundings. Have you seen a dog? The way he sits, firstly, he wags his tail. He cleans the place where he sits. And we human beings, we are sitting, we are just throwing the garbage here and there. We think that, okay, we are in the school only. It's not our home. Let's throw the, whatever you are eating, you are throwing the wrappers here and there and whatever we feel like. Fine. We should start at least with small gestures, with small acts only. Clear? So this is the gist. Now you are having the books beta with you, everyone. Wait, I need to share the screen. There is some problem with the mouse today again. Okay, now see the screen. The following article was written by Nani Palkhiwala, underline beta, you need to know the names, and published in the Indian Express on 24th November 1994. I told you this is an article only. Fine, this is not a story or short story the way we have read others. So this is an article which was published on 24th November 1994. The issues that he raised regarding the declining health of the earth continue to have relevance. It means in 1994 he raised this issue. You very well imagine, until date it is relevant, and in coming years also it is relevant, because we need plants, we need environment, we need greenery the last day of this earth maybe. So this is the universal concept and long-lasting concept. One cannot recall any movement. On the very first page, Dia, do you have a book with you? Then look at your books only. Okay. If you do not have the book, then you will be using the screens. One cannot recall any movement in world history which has gripped the imagination of the entire human race so completely and so rapidly as the Green Movement, which started nearly 25 years ago. It is 25 years ago, but it is more than that now, fine? In 1972, the world's first nationwide Green Party was founded in New Zealand. Underline this, Vita. This is the main information. When did that Green Movement start? In 1972 in New Zealand, fine? Since then, the movement has not looked back. It has not, it started at a smaller scale in New Zealand, but then after that, it took a universal turn, global turn, I must say. Many countries, many organizations, political parties, politicians, many notable, you can say, personalities, they joined this movement, and it has not turned back since then. We have shifted one hopes irrevocably. Irrevocably, beta, it means unchangeable. Write down the meaning. It is not written in your book. Which cannot be changed. Which cannot be altered. Irrevocably. The way you pronounce it, sometimes also you're not able to. Try to speak. It is like a tongue twister only. Irrevocably, okay? From the mechanistic view to a holistic and ecological view of the world, it is a shift in human perceptions as revolutionary as that introduced by Copernicus, who taught mankind in the 16th century that the Earth and the other planets revolve round the sun. For the first time in human history, there is a growing worldwide consciousness that the earth itself is a living organism, an enormous being of which we are parts. It has its own metabolic needs and vital processes which need to be respected and preserved. Fine. Now I would be explaining this whatsoever I have read. So, for the first time ever in history, there is a growing awareness, Vita, awareness that Earth itself is a living organism. Just like other human beings, Earth is also a living organism. It has its own metabolic needs. The way we people need food, air, water to survive. Similarly, this Earth is a living organism, and it also needs, it also has its essential processes. It also has its metabolic needs. The way we people are living life, Earth also wants to breathe properly. And for its breathing movement to go on in an uninterrupted manner, we people need to put in efforts. Clear? The science pertaining to actually Earth's life shows that it is like a patient only. And people have realized it. I'm not saying all the people are saying. There are people who are environmentalists, who are working for the welfare of the earth. Fine. Writer is saying that there is worldwide consciousness. Now, people are becoming more conscious that earth is also a living organism and we must safeguard it. We must save it. And it must be respected. It must be preserved. Clear? In 16th century, when it was discovered about the planets, at the same time, respect for the earth is also there. Now they're going to discuss how earth is becoming a patient in declining health. Vita, ecological, you know that which is related to plants. Fine. Ecological view is that which is related to nature only. Clear? So the earth's vital signs reveal a patient in declining health. All the signs show that earth is becoming a patient day by day. We have begun to realize our ethical obligations to be good stewards of the planet. Who is a steward? You know, we have air hostess, we have flight stewards also. who are flying the, you can say, taking care of the every passenger in the plane. Fine. Similarly, we are also the stewards. We are to take care of the planet, and we have to be responsible trustees of the legacy to future generations, because we have borrowed this earth from the posterity. We have borrowed this earth from the future generations. That's why we must have to take care of it as a guard. Fine. Now, further, Nani Palkhiwala has discussed about the concept of sustainable development. Underline, this is a complete question in itself. The concept of sustainable development I discussed in the beginning only. It was popularized in 1987 by the World Commission on Environment and Development. In its report, it defined the idea as development that meets the needs of the present without compromising the ability of future generations to meet their needs. Without stripping the natural world of resources future generations would need. Use it. Use all the natural resources, but to that an extent that it is left for others also. The way I have given example of Gajar ka Halwa that your mother has made, she would be relishing it. She would be sharing it with other members of the family also. Fine. Similarly, we have to relish the nature, but we have to leave it for others also. And your generations are going to have this. Fine. We cannot be mean in this way. We cannot distort the nature that I have used it. I'm going to die and left people, coming generations will see to it. No, we have to be very responsible. We should understand what sustainable development is. We are left with 3 minutes only. And this example, which is beautiful one, even I have discussed with you in the zoo at Lusaka, Zambia. Underline, this is another question, beta. There is a cage where the notice reads, the world's most dangerous animal. Inside the cage, there is no animal, but a mirror where you see yourself. Thanks to the efforts of a number of agencies in different countries, a new awareness has now dawned upon the most dangerous animal in the world. He has realized the wisdom of shifting from a system based on domination to based on partnership. So now man has become quite aware, responsible, that yes, it is a message. What the projection in Lusaka, Zambia, it is a message for the human beings that you are the most dangerous animal because you are distorting that chain of natural resources, and you yourself will be facing it also. Clear? So he has realized, writer is saying, man has realized the wisdom, this concept that yes, we have to understand that this is a concept of partnership. This is not to be done basis on domination. Fine. I won't be continuing further because there are facts only, and we would be continuing tomorrow. If you have any doubts so far, you can ask me. Any doubts to anyone? We're left with only 1-2 minutes. If you could not understand any word, if you could not understand any point written on the board or any concept, then you can ask me now. All clear? Everything is clear to everyone? Send me thumbs up quickly, then I will, meet is going to end only. So you would read this so far. I would be asking to, and tomorrow if you do not unmute yourself, now I tell you. Fine. I would be asking questions from the article, whatever we have read today, and then I will continue. Otherwise, I won't. Okay. Dear, ethical obligations are our moral duties. Okay, we have to, it is our moral duty to safeguard our nature. Okay, it's clear to you now? Any other doubt? Okay, fine, beta.